Taoiseach, today somewhere in this country there may very well be a victim of rape, incest or abuse who is contemplating facing their tormentor in seeking justice and retribution. However, recent decisions by the Central Criminal Court send out a very disturbing message to Taoiseach. And what I'm saying here today is, as a Parliament and as a society, we have to give encouragement to people who have been abused, who have been betrayed by their loved ones or who have been betrayed by this state, to know that if they come forward, they will seek justice and they will be listened to and they will be believed. Taoiseach, would you agree that the sentence as handed out by the Central Criminal Court...
Sorry, Deputy, I have to interfere here and I don't like doing this. This is a matter that we...
I'm not questioning the legitimacy.
...are entirely separate and the decisions of the court are entirely separate. Yes. That was the reason why I didn't allow topical issues today on the basis of the advice that I was given, having checked, because I gathered it would be the case myself, but we cannot discuss in here decisions of the court or criticise those who make those decisions.
I respect your ruling, and I'm not in here to question the legitimacy of the Central Criminal Court, but what I am in here to raise is the legitimate concerns of the Irish people. There is huge anger out there, Taoiseach.
I know, but I mean,
I don't want to make a political football out of this and out of the suffering of Fiona Doyle. But as our duty in here is to respond, and respond we must. Now, Taoiseach, would you agree that there is major concern and we need to do something about it? Would you agree that we need to establish a sentencing council? Would you agree that the Criminal Court of Appeal needs to have permanent specialist judges sitting there so they can adjudicate on sentencing, and we need to have clear guidelines in the area of rape and abuse? This state has betrayed children previously, Taoiseach. It has apologised, but we need to give everybody encouragement that they know that if they come forward, they will be listened to, they will be believed, and they will be vindicated. And I'm saying here today, Taoiseach, what is the government's response in the terms and the concerns of the sentencing arrangements in rape in this particular case?
No, you cannot. I'm sorry, I have to interfere here. You cannot ask the Taoiseach or anybody else or a minister to give an opinion on a decision of the court.
Decisions or judgments of a duly constituted court
cannot be subjected to review or discussion in this House, as the House is not a judicial body. I have to put that on the record. That is the position.
Can I raise the issue of legislation in terms of mandatory sentencing?
I'm sorry, but I have to rule it out. Otherwise, I'd be irresponsible in my duty.
I accept that. Taoiseach, would you...
No, there's no point of order here. We're on leaders' questions now, and I'm asking you to adhere to the ruling of the chair on this particular issue. And don't put us all in a very embarrassing position.
I don't want to have difficulty with the chair, but what I am raising...
But you're long enough around to know that we cannot discuss a decision of a court in this... Chamber.
I agree with you, Kian Corla. And Kian Corla, I'm actually in the Oireachtas 20 years, and it beggars belief that we can't raise an issue of legitimate public concern. We're not a judicial body.
They're independent of
us. And what I'm raising is the substance of the issue with regard to the need for a sentencing council, the need for us to look at the issue of mandatory sentencing and clear guidelines to ensure that we have consistency in our sentencing, and that we give encouragement to people who have been raped, who have been abused, that they know if they come forward, they will be vindicated and fair sentencing will be handed out on perpetrators.
We can't interfere with the judicial decisions of an independent court. And you cannot ask a Taoiseach to give an opinion, or anybody else, an opinion on a court decision in this chamber. We are not a judicial body. I'd ask the Taoiseach if he wishes to respond, but please recognise the constraints on which we operate. Yes, what's your point of order?
Well, my point of order is, can this issue, without dealing with a specific case, be dealt with under promised legislation?
Well, I mean, that's a matter for the government of the day to decide whether they're bringing forward legislation.
Okay, so it would be an order for me to raise this.
It's a matter for the government of the day as to whether they bring forward independent legislation, but not that we cannot debate in this chamber a decision of a court. You're well aware of that yourself, Deputy.
Taoiseach. Concola, I admire the the courage of Fiona Doyle in doing what she did. This case has filled the nation with revulsion. Revulsion. The defilement of a child and continuous rape over a 10-year period. I would like to believe that others who have or are subject to a rape or incest or crimes of this horrific nature would not lose courage in coming forward to say their piece. The situation here is that this sentence and case has now been referred to the Court of Criminal Appeal for priority assessment. The question of mandatory reporting sentencing is an issue that has been raised here before in regard to particular crimes over the years. The matter for government to reflect on as part of a situation insofar as introducing legislation is concerned. I accept your clarification, Account Cola. It is not open to me or anybody else in the House here to refer to the nature or the extent of the sentence. But I do want to repeat that the case being brought to public scrutiny by Fiona Doyle is an act of courage on her behalf, and I admire her for that. And as I say, it has filled the people with a sense of revulsion. I trust that the Court of Criminal Appeal will deal with the referencing of this to as a priority. And I would hope, following the question raised by Deputy Kelleher, that others who are abused or horrifically defiled, as in this case, will not lose courage and will have the courage to speak out as Ms. Doyle has done.
Deputy Kelleher.
Well, Count Corla, Fiona Doyle did show great courage and bravery in coming forward. But the issue of concern here is the potential fallout that this will raise in terms of people who may be very concerned about being brave, waiving their right to privacy, coming forward, opening up to the world, the torment that they went through. And we clearly have an obligation in this House to act. As I said previously, Taoiseach, here, you know, this state in previous times, you know, reneged its rights and its responsibilities and duties to protect children in its own care and in the care of others who were acting on behalf of the state. We apologise in this House. We had a children's referendum. But what we must do now as a legislator and as a parliament and as a people is ensure that anybody who's out there who has been raped, who has been abused, or is presently being raped and abused, that they believe that if they walk into a Garda station, if they go to a social worker, that they will be vindicated and that the state will protect their rights and ensure that they seek justice in the courts of this country. And I'm not questioning any individual court case, but fallout can set precedents and it can have a very damaging effect on how we judge ourselves and how we view crimes in this society.
Thank you.
And our children need that protection.
Well, let me say to Deputy Kelleher, one of the statements made by this government was the appointment of a senior cabinet minister dealing with children and youth affairs. And I commend Minister Fitzgerald for the work that has been done to date in this regard, in drawing all the elements of child care and child connection into one single department, in having had a referendum, in putting together the excellent work being done by the Garda Vetting Bureau in respect of legislation dealing with mandatory reporting and a whole range of issues that are concerned with the welfare of children, both now and for the future. The issue raised by Deputy Kelleher in respect of the fallout from this particular case is one that concerns us all. The case has been referred for priority treatment to the Court of Criminal Appeal, and I hope that happens as a matter of urgency. So the sentence itself, in that sense, Deputy, has not been finally dealt with until the Court of Criminal Appeal makes its decision. But let me repeat again that the courage of Fiona Doyle speaks for itself. What that young girl went through, what she had to put up with in the horrific and barbaric treatment of her was something that very few people can speak in the way that she speaks, because she's been through that. And that's why it fills people with a sense of revulsion. Unfortunately, it's not the only such case that has come to light over the years, and you're well aware of these, where other horrific instances have happened. And that's why, from my own perspective, it was very important to be able to appoint at government level a senior position dealing with the legislation that will protect our children, all our children, for the future. This is a horrific case of the past. It's not over yet. And as I said, a revulsion is a word that comes to people's minds and tongues in talking to them today all over the country because of what happened here. And I do hope, Deputy Kelleher, that the Court of Criminal Appeal will deal with this case as a matter of urgency in respect of what has been referred to it. Again, I admire Fiona Doyle, and I hope that she speaks for all those young people who have been the victims of this kind of incest or rape or brutality, which has had a devastating impact on their own mental strength and on their own relations with their individual families. So I do hope the matter will be examined and dealt with by the Court of Criminal Appeal in the shortest possible time. Clearly, you're aware of the constraints that are upon me in this regard.